Another Tuesday evening Bible study, worship, and fellowship service in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Here today at the Farm Reed Park, Oakland, California, where we joyfully worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ outdoors. We spread the gospel of Jesus Christ outdoors. We're very excited about God using us in that way, only by His mercy and grace.
Praise the Lord.
So, the title of the message is this: God's eternal salvation, which only comes through our trust in Jesus Christ alone, is rich to all that call upon Him. God's eternal salvation, which only comes through our trust in Jesus Christ alone, is rich to all that call upon Him. You know what? His eternal salvation is rich to all that call upon Him. It's no difference with God. He doesn't care about race. He doesn't care about how much money we have. He doesn't care about how many titles or degrees we obtain. He doesn't care about gender. He doesn't care about none of that stuff. All He cares about is we're trusting in Jesus Christ alone with a heart of repentance towards our sin nature, looking to Him, being Holy Spirit led and not fleshly driven. And as we do that, we will have a heart to turn away from sin in our life. We will not want to live in sin because the Holy Spirit will lead us away from that lifestyle. We won't be perfect. No, we won't. Keep it 100. Never perfect. Never can we be. But through Jesus Christ, through Jesus Christ who is perfect, He perfects our imperfections on the daily. Amen. So Romans 10:9-13. We're talking about God's eternal salvation, which only comes through our trust in Jesus Christ alone, is rich to all that call upon Him. Rich to all people. Romans 10:9-13. And it says, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God hath raised Him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Verse 10.
Amen.
For with the heart, God bless you, praise God. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Verse 11. For the scripture says, whosoever believeth on Him shall not be ashamed. You know what that means? We trust in Christ alone, we shall not be ashamed. So it doesn't matter about where we come from, where we grew up at, how much money we have, how many titles we obtain. It doesn't matter about race or any of that stuff. We won't be ashamed when we trust in Christ alone. See, the devil want to make us be ashamed of who we are. He wants us to make us be ashamed of who Christ has chosen us to be by His mercy and grace. Amen. That's why He tries to place so many things in our way to derail us. That's all He can do is derail us. He can't stop us because Christ, all the power belongs to Him, who is God. So the enemy can't stop us, but He tries to derail us. And it's only through the mercy and grace of God, through Christ, through the Holy Spirit, that we can have the power to rebuke any of His schemes. Amen. Because He's going to try every day to derail us. So let's go to verse 12. Watch this. For there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon Him.
Amen.
Is that the word it says? The same Lord of all is rich to all of us that call upon Him. So when we call upon God, who is Jesus Christ, that means we're trusting in Him. We're looking to Him. He's our everything. We're not looking to our own ways of doing things. Will we be perfect? No. But we trust in Him, and He will keep us. Amen. Verse 13 says, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall what? Shall be saved. It didn't say whosoever shall go to church 7 days a week on twice on Sunday. It didn't say whosoever shall pay their tithes and offer. It didn't say whosoever has a certain title or of a certain church denomination. It said whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And that's what God is looking, calling us to do, is trust in Him. We have to seek His face and not His hand. See, many of us, we seek His hand. We want blessings. We want miracles. We want what He can give us. But seeking the face of God, seeking His whole being, His whole person, we want to be in Your presence every single day. We want to be where You're at. That's seeking the face of God. That's seeking who He is. And that's what He wants. That's where we was at. We got kicked out of the Garden of Eden. We got kicked out of God's presence. But thanks be to God, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we had a victory over sin's destructive power controlling our lives. Doesn't mean we will be perfect. Doesn't mean we won't make a mistake. Doesn't mean we won't struggle in this life. But it means, what it does mean is that we have total victory when we trust in Him. And we can wake up in this morning and say, I have the victory in you alone, Christ Jesus. I have the victory in you, God, when I trust in you, when I believe in you, I have victory. But if we trust in our own ways of doing things, we trust in our own ways of thinking, then that's where we mess up at. Each and every one of us goes down that path, think we can do things our way, right? But every time, every single time, God shows us that, okay, that's not the way. Don't go that way, my son. Don't go that way, my daughter. I don't want you to go that way. Because that way is the road of destruction. Amen. It doesn't mean that God is not a joy killer. He's not a kill joy. He's the giver of joy. So the whole point of the matter, the joy of the Lord is our strength. Nehemiah 8:10 tells us that, right? The joy of the Lord is our strength. So if our strength is in the joy of the Lord, that means that can't nothing in this world snatch it away from us. Amen? Can't nothing in this world snatch the joy of the Lord away from us, because it's in Him.
Amen.
And that's what? Eternal. It's eternal joy. It's not a temporary joy. It's not a temporary peace. It's an eternal peace.
Right.
Because no matter what we go through in this life, no matter what we face in this life, we know that we have the victory in Christ alone.
Come on,
amen. That doesn't mean, like, I keep it 100. It doesn't mean we'll be perfect. We can never be in this flesh, because the flesh always going to want to go the opposite direction, what the way the Holy Spirit tells us to go, the way that God tells them to go. But it does mean we have the victory in this life. And in the life to come, we have God's eternal salvation. Hallelujah. When we trust in Him alone. Praise so God's eternal salvation, which only comes through our trust in Jesus Christ alone, is rich to all that call upon Him. When it says rich, that means overflowing. It's rich. It's non-stop. Amen? That eternal salvation is rich, meaning it's nothing that can snatch that away from us. Amen? The whole point of the matter is, we're not saved by works. We're saved through our faith in Christ alone, by grace through faith. Amen. Now, the works we do is because Christ lives in our heart. We want to live according to the Holy Spirit leads us. Amen.
I've been here all day. I've been here. What church?
We call Brothers in Christ Living Waters Ministries. We have service here every Sunday, outdoors, 12:30. We're outdoor ministry. We do everything outside.
Oh, really?
Yep, everything outside. We do everything outdoors.
I've been here Sunday.
So Sunday, 12:30. And Tuesdays at 6:30.
Oh, okay.
So just come
on
by.
Right now.
Yep.
Okay.
So come by and worship, fellowship. It's all good. Yeah. And we do a lot in the community with the kids.
You got any cords?
Yeah. Hold on.
I'm sorry.
No, it's good. It's on tape, but I'll pause it. Praise God. We're back. So God's eternal salvation, which only comes through our trust in Jesus Christ alone, is rich to all that call upon Him. We must get this in our hearts, mind, and spirit. God wants us to understand that He wants all of us to be in His presence, amen. And He is no respecter of persons, amen. He's no respecter of person. So you must understand this. And like we stated earlier, calling on the Lord is seeking His face, and not His hand. It's not just saying, Lord, help me when I'm in a jam. Lord, do this for me and do that for me. No, it's really just trusting in Him alone with the heart of repentance towards our sinners, or being Holy Spirit led, not flesh driven. That's what it means for us to call on the Lord. For us to call on Jesus Christ, to trust in Him, okay? So we read Romans 10, 9-13. Let's get as far as my spirit. God's eternal salvation was only come through our trust in Jesus Christ alone, is rich to all that call upon Him. Praise God for the message. Praise
amen,
God.
Amen.